Power outages in February left all of us worried about the reliability of the Texas power grid. One possible solution being looked at is increasing the number of microgrids.
News 4 troubleshooter Jay Avila explains what they are and how they could help keep power flowing when the big generators fail.
A microgrid can be a natural gas generator like this one that provides backup power in an emergency and also reduces the strain on the overall power grid. When Winter Storm Uri knocked out power to millions of Texans,
528.
The elderly residents at the Holly Hall Retirement Community in Houston never lost their heat, lights, or warm meals.
Our operations continued as if it was the week before. Our residents would not have known that there was a storm outside and what was going on if they hadn't been watching the news.
A few years ago, the owners installed a microgrid, a huge on-site generator fueled by natural gas piped in from underground. The company that set up and monitors their system is called Enchanted Rock. It has 143 microgrids throughout Texas, including some that kept HEB and Walmart stores here in San Antonio open during the freeze, as well as some water districts and healthcare facilities.
Well, microgrids were able to provide to those companies continuous electricity throughout the entire cold spell.
The company maintains the equipment and the fuel supply so they're ready when an emergency strikes, and tracks the energy market so they can sell extra power through ERCOT when supplies are tight.
It's what we call a dual-purpose microgrid. It protects our host customer from an outage. It also provides additional resource into the grid when they need it most. Sometimes it's when there's a heat wave, sometimes when it's a cold snap.
Microgrids aren't as vulnerable to weather damage because they don't have above-ground transmission equipment. Natural gas is often used now, but other clean sources could be used in the future. CPS Energy and Joint Base San Antonio tested a microgrid using on-site solar panels and storage batteries. CPS Energy has been working with microgrid companies for a couple of years now, so we'll likely see more companies and utilities installing them. I'm News 4 troubleshooter Jay Avila.